tell us then what your expectations are right now, because many companies had a had an objective at the start of the year. They've changed that mid first half because of what's happened. And now in your case, you've seen things recover and pick up yet again. My understanding is back in April, you reduced your full year sales target for the battery business from about 15 trillion won to about 13 trillion, roughly about 10-15% lower. Is that still your full year target, that reduced target, or do you see the need to re-increase that target back to the original?
Yeah, obviously we saw some impact, especially in the first half, especially in March, April timeframe. For example, United States, China, those countries. But we have seen robust demand coming from European countries. We have actually not seen any slowdown in European demand. And we have some more production to boost in the second half of the year. So we do not have a complete tally yet as far as total year production is concerned.
Right.
But I think it will be either very close to our projection originally that we have had, or if there's any impact, it will be relatively small.
Any of the things that you're hearing that you just mentioned there, or any other things that you're probably seeing recently, making you rethink your targets for production capacity for the battery business? I believe the initial one was 100 gigawatt hours. This year, that goes up to 120 by 2021. Do you need to look at that and maybe increase that, or does that still make sense to you?
Yeah, pretty much we stick to our plan to continue to invest in our capacity. As you mentioned, we have about 100 gigawatt capacity by the end of the year, but by 2022, we should have about 220. Gigawatt capacity. I think the penetration rate of EV is still relatively low, about 2.6% last year. This year, maybe about 3%. Even with the robust market growth of about 40% for the next 5-6 years, we have to continue to invest in our capacity to secure that over 220 gigawatt by 2022. As you know, we have unfulfilled order book of close to $125 billion. So that's a lot of batteries to be made.
Your CapEx plans for the next, is it still 5 trillion won for this year? And since you mentioned 2022, do you have a figure already of what you plan to spend next year and the year after that?
I think in battery alone, we will be spending about 3 trillion this year. There was the same or even slight increase from what we had in the plan. And I think that ratio of CapEx will continue in years to come.
The market's taken a look at your stock and has obviously, you obviously would know as well that your stock has gone up substantially. I think you entered either the top five or you were the top six largest company on the South Korean exchange at some point. A lot of that had to do with speculation that the partnership with Tesla and the battery business is doing quite well. Can you tell us a little bit more about how that engagement is going now, what you're looking forward to, and how you actually plan to fend off competition?
We should be able to secure a production capacity of roughly about 25 gigawatt, which is equivalent of about 400,000 EVs by the end of this year. So I think we are very well poised to meet the demands of various customers, including the customer that you just mentioned.
Okay, fair enough. What's your assumption then on how quickly you think the battery business overall will grow every year, and you expect as a company your sales will exceed that industry growth?
Yeah, I think we expect about $13 trillion from our battery business this year. They will grow to about $30 trillion by 2025. There's a very robust market growth driven by, again, emission regulation and government policy. So I think our battery business will at least grow at the speed of the market.
Okay.
Our goal is to either maintain or strengthen our market position in many years to come. So we hope to grow faster than the market.
this spat that's going on between the Americans and the Chinese, has that affected you in any way?
I think, you know, there has been some slight issues like tariffs of certain materials that we are trying to bring from, right, from China to US and vice versa. However, because of our regional manufacturing strategy, we have a good supply chain capability in the United States. I think there are ways that we can operate within the framework of current Sino US relationship. So impact is pretty limited.
There were some reports early this year that you were reviewing, one of the possibilities was spinning off the battery business, maybe an IPO. I'm curious, have there been updates on that front? Should we expect the battery business to be an IPO at some point?
Right. We always examine options to strengthen our competitiveness in our battery business and enhance value to our shareholders.
Right.
However, no specific decision has been taken yet at this moment. And because of that, nothing else for me to comment.
Okay. You don't need the money, right?
Everybody needs money, by the way.
But what about, this might be related to that or might not be, what about the cobalt part of the supply chain? I mean, you're well aware that securing that mineral comes at a massive environmental and even human cost. You've made some progress. The industry as a whole has made some progress. What do you think right now is the remaining sticking point that everyone needs to get over?
There's this cobalt mined at the Republic of Congo.
Right.
Became an issue. LG Chem has actively engaged all of our stakeholders to mitigate the risk that this particular one poses.
Right.
First, we have mapped the entire cobalt supply chain from upstream all the way to downstream. This process helps us keep track of where the material we use for battery is sourced and how they are used in every step of our global supply chain. With this map in hand, we have suppliers audited as instructed by the OECD due diligence guidance, which will be enforced from next year in Europe in earnest. To keep the chain as sustainable as possible, we have worked collectively with like-minded stakeholders by joining the global initiatives such as RMI or Responsible Minerals Initiatives. So we are very committed to this particular issue.
It is an important issue, and thank you for clarifying that. Are you still getting supplies though from Congo, or are you fully out of that market?
Cobalt is coming from several countries, including Congo, but we follow
Understood.
All those, what we call RMI or Responsible Management of Metals process.